Hello. Today we're going to be building the bottle rocket blaster from KiwiCo Labs. I hope you guys are ready to get building in 3, 2, 1. So first you're going to want to grab these two pieces. Make sure that the notch is on the right side of the wood. Then you're going to line up these two little feet on the bottom of the wood panel into the light blue base, just like that. Next, grab a yellow T-nut and slot that into the wood. It doesn't matter from which side you come in, as long as it's resting all the way in that little slot. Then grab a green bolt and push it up through the bottom of the light blue base. Make sure to tighten it down all the way. The T-nut won't hold everything in place very well unless everything is nice and snug. Next, you're going to slide in this piece. Make sure that the big circle cutout lines up with the big bump on the light blue base. Double check that it looks like this. Also make sure that these little notches are on the same side. If not, flip that piece over so they match. Next, grab one of these pieces. It really helps to put the little foot in the base first and then rotate it into place. You might need some wiggling, but it should go on. To secure it all into place, grab a T-nut and another green bolt. Next, grab the other tall piece with the little notch in it and do the same. It's not super critical if these are flipped, but it helps. No worries if you've already assembled it backwards. Next, grab this blue foam and then separate it all out so you end up with 4 pieces total. These are going to act as the feet to your detonator. Peel off the sticker backer and place 1 foot here, 1 foot over there. And lastly, use one of the big donut pieces for the biggest area. Perfect. Then we're going to flip it back over and start assembling some of the syringe. So grab your syringe and make sure that the printing is facing you. When you slot it in, it should match up with 3 holes at the top of the detonator. Next, we're going to grab this wood circle. Make sure that the logo is facing up and closer to you when you put it on the detonator. So just like we assembled the bottom of the base, we're going to use a lot of T-slots and green bolts here to tighten everything down and hold it into place. If you're having trouble getting things lined up, then double check to make sure that the syringe is facing the correct direction. The front side should be flat and the printing should be facing you. All right, next, let's assemble the plunger. This will create a really strong airtight seal for your detonator. So it's a pretty tight fit. You're going to need to use a little bit of extra muscle, and if you're having a hard time, you can try wiggling it back and forth or getting a grown-up assistant. Next, grab this teeny tiny tube and the T-shaped piece from your toolbox. Push the tiny tube as far as you can onto the branch in the middle. It doesn't need to go on super far. As long as it feels really snug, you're good to go. This far is plenty enough. All right, now for the rest of our tubing. So there are 3 different lengths of tubing. Find the shortest one, set it aside for now. Then, the middle length and the longest length, and set those on either side of your branches. So same thing here, you want to push on both of those tubes as hard as they can go. Just try to keep track of which side is the long tube and which side is the short tube. So get the shortest tube and stick that on as hard as you can into the opening of the syringe. It can be kind of tricky, but make sure you have at least that much length. Then squish in both the tubes so they're coming out the sides of the detonator. If the whole thing gets disconnected from the syringe while you're doing this, no worries. Just pop it right back on and see if you can squish it on a little harder this time. That should be good. All right, then you're gonna wanna turn your whole detonator around. It's time to install the reservoir. Slide the reservoir in through the big circle and then get that 4th foam piece that we never used and put it underneath the bottle. Use the bottle as a guide to make sure that everything's aligned properly. This will help make sure that your water reservoir stays in place. Next, grab your valve. This red piece points in the direction that air and water will be able to flow. So it's very important that this red piece is pointing in the right direction. Next, we're going to fit the valve in the bottom of the light blue cork. Squish these two together as far as they'll go. Make sure that their little red valve inside is pointing towards the light blue cork. Very important. Next, take your shortest piece of tubing and slide that onto the other end of the valve. Next, you're gonna take that middle length of tube. The middle length tube needs to grab onto the valve that's inside of the stopper. This step is kind of tricky and can take quite a bit of muscle. So to make things a little bit easier, you can kind of stretch out the end of the middle length tube either with a pencil or with the other valve that comes in your toolbox. This should make things a lot easier to assemble. This step can be really tricky, but really tight tubing will be awesome for getting really big blasts on your rocket. Next, we're going to put the whole short end into your bottle reservoir. And we can tuck that extra cord into those little notches. Ta-da! Bottle reservoir. All right, next up, the launch pad. We're going to get another valve and slide it into the cork. Again, we're going to want to make sure that the valve is pointing towards the cork. Very important. Next, we're going to push both of these into our clear base. This part can also take some muscle, so you can try rocking this back and forth or getting a grown-up for help. The goal is to get it seated all the way down. Next, take the longer cord from your detonator and slide it in through the hole in the side of the base. Flip your base over, then take that long end and attach it to the bottom of the valve. Make sure it's nice and snug. Then you can pull out the extra cord, flip it back over, and you have a launch pad. All right, before we move on, let's make sure that our launch pad and detonator are assembled correctly. Try out the plunger. You should be able to pull the handle all the way up and push it all the way back down. When you push down, air should be coming out of the red stopper. If air isn't coming out, then double check that all of your tubes are connected and that your valves are pointing in the correct direction. For more details, go back to part A, step 17, and part B, step 1. Once everything's working well, put the chemical tube into your launch pad and move on. All right, time for the rocket build. Assemble the fins into these slots. Grab the fins and slide them straight down. It might be tempting to try to slide them in like this, kind of at an angle, but make sure that you're sliding along the slot so that the slot goes straight up and straight down. It's pretty snug, but you can really pull on these. Perfect. And then complete all four. The inside curve of the fin should match the inside curve of the connector. Next, you're going to want to screw that onto the end of your bottle. Ta-da! All right, so we finished building and we're ready to get launching. But wait, before we go outside, there's two really important things we need to remember for safety. The first is that you should always assume the rocket is pressurized. It can be pressurized from air or for chemical reactions. So even if it's not blowing just yet, wait and see. The second thing to remember is that you should never point it anywhere besides up. Again, we're assuming it's always pressurized, so you never want to put your face over the rocket or point it anywhere like, you know, at an enemy or a friend or a duck or anything like that. So now that we've covered those safety rules, let's go outside. All right, so the most important part of any rocket launch is to prepare the launch site. So first you're going to want to put your launcher and your launch pad over in a very good and well-considered spot, and everything else can get set to the side for now. So the launch pad needs to be on a flat and stable surface and pointing straight up. And the chemicals that blast out the back will be fine if it's for one or two launches on grass. But if you're planning on doing a lot of rocket launches today, you're gonna wanna make sure that it does it on concrete. Side note for parents, baking soda may discolor colored concrete. So do a test in a small and inconspicuous area before deciding to do a full day's worth of launches in the center of your beautiful driveway. The next most important thing is to make sure that there's just nothing above where you're gonna be launching a rocket. Sounds obvious, but sometimes it's easy to forget when you're excited about rockets. So make sure that your face is never over here, that there's no garage or carport or house awning above where the rocket's gonna be launching, and that you've got a perfect and clear trajectory up to the skies. So the only thing you need from home for this rocket launch is water. So before we get any chemicals in our rocket, we're gonna have to prime the launch pad. So what we're gonna do first is turn this around and take our bottle reservoir out and fill it up with water. We're gonna reassemble the little stopper, put it back in its housing. Put that all together, and we're ready to go. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is the plunger is pushed all the way down, and then you're gonna put 1 foot or both feet, depending on what's comfortable. Hold it up here, and then pull up. And it will be pretty hard to pull, but that's because you're moving a bunch of water through a really tiny space. So now that the plunger is all the way up, you should see your syringe is actually filled with water. So when I press down, wow, you should get all the water to bubble out the top. So now that we know that everything's working properly, we're ready to prepare for our first launch. So every time you get ready to launch, make sure that this tube is empty of water. So just give it a little dump, set that where you want it to launch from, make sure that the reservoir is full of water, and then we're going to prime the detonator. So what that means is we're going to pull the handle all the way up. Because our rocket launches with a chemical reaction, every second counts. And so you're gonna wanna be able to launch as fast as possible. So priming the detonator will make sure that you can deliver the water to the system quickly, efficiently, and get a really good boom. So now that it's primed, we're ready to add the secret special ingredient for this rocket launch, and that's chemicals. So we can get out 1 baking soda and 1 citric acid. It's very important that you put 1 of each, otherwise there's no chemical reaction. So something to keep in mind while we're launching is that these chemicals mixing together with water is what's creating our rocket fuel. And so as soon as any water touches either of these, they're ready to start creating fuel and expanding into gas. That means we're going to want to be extra careful about how quickly and efficiently we're doing things, as well as making sure that these don't get wet. So a little bit of extra care will make your rocket go a lot farther. We're gonna make sure this is empty, and we're gonna put 1 scoop of citric acid in here, and then 1 scoop of baking soda, and then try to smash the rocket on as fast as possible. So let's go. So 1 scoop of citric acid, whoosh. And it's fine if it doesn't all get in there as long as it's most. And then we're gonna go immediately and do 1 scoop of baking soda. Again, fine if it's a little messy. And then we're gonna try to smush that bottle on as far as it goes, and launch. And wait, always wait. If you count to 10 and your rocket still hasn't launched, you can do a second pump. Wow. If you pull up on the plunger and absolutely no water is coming up into that syringe, it could be because a hose is disconnected, so check there, or it could be because you just ran out of water. So pause and refill before you continue. Now obviously if you go to plunge the detonator and all the water sprays out the bottom, you've got a hose disconnect. So anytime there's water coming out anywhere it's not supposed to, just go and double check all those connection points and make sure that everything's nice and snug together. Press in a little tighter. And if it's happening a couple times in a row or again and again, then just go get an adult to help you squish it on nice and tight. If you're pushing down and it doesn't want to go, or if it keeps popping all of the tubes loose, then you're gonna wanna check your duckbill valve. So remember, 1 duckbill valve is in here and the other duckbill valve is in here. And it's very important that those are facing the right direction. So this valve, you'll want the red piece to be pointing this way because you need the water to go in that direction. And for the launch pad, you'll have to take it out and make sure that that duckbill valve is pointing in that direction because that's the way you want the water to go. Easy way to think about it is if it looks like a little fingertip, just check where it's pointing and make sure that's where you want the water to go, that way. So if you're going to launch, and you see really awesome fizzing, but it's immediately just spilling out the bottom and the rocket's not going anywhere, you just don't have a good enough seal. So really lean and squish that rocket on. And if you can't feel like you can get a good enough seal, then you can always wiggle this a little bit looser so that a bigger part of it is sticking out. Try again. It's a little cheat code. If you did make sure you added baking soda and citric acid and still no fizzing is happening, then you're gonna wanna make sure that those reactions haven't already happened and all the gas hasn't escaped. So make sure that it looks like a nice dry powder. There's the baking soda and there's the citric acid. And if you pour some water on both of them, see, it's still fizzing. So you can test it on just the pavement and see if those chemicals are still good to react. If no fizzing happens, that means that those chemicals are no longer good. So go ahead and open your second bag of chemicals to try those out, or head to the store and get some replacements. Okay, now that we've got troubleshooting out of the way, let's talk about the two best strategies to get the biggest boom out of your rocket. The first thing to keep in mind is that you want your chemical reaction to wait until you get into the sealed bottle rocket to start. So you don't want any moisture or any liquid in your chemicals before they're going in here. And you wanna make sure your rocket's a little bit more dry, shake out all that extra water before you start your next launch. The second thing to keep in mind is that you want a really, really tight seal from your bottle rocket to your base. That's gonna allow a ton more pressure to build up, and so a ton more pressure to release at launch. So just give it a good extra squeeze and lean on it a bit to make sure you've got a great seal. With both of those things in mind, you should have great launches. If you run out of chemicals and you wanna keep launching, we tried to design our rocket to launch with commonly found ingredients that you could get at the store, baking soda and citric acid. But if you can't find citric acid, then you can actually substitute it for white vinegar, also available at most grocery stores. All right, now time for some rocket science. This rocket works the same way that most rockets do. Basically, it's blasting something out the bottom, which pushes the rocket upwards. In our case, we're using a chemical reaction. So baking soda, which is a base, mixes with citric acid, which is an acid. And these two guys don't like each other very much. So when you mix them all together with water, they fizz and create a ton of CO2, this extra gas. And so it expands and expands and expands. And when it's locked inside of the rocket, it has nowhere to go. So the pressure builds and builds and builds until it overcomes the seal on the stopper and all the gas rushes out the bottom. And that big rush of air is the only thing that's pushing your rocket all the way up. And that's rocket science. Pretty simple, huh? Thanks so much for building with me today. I hope you guys had a blast. If you want to see more really fun and easy to follow builds like what we did today, make sure to like and subscribe to our channel. Thanks, bye.